Welcome all to another video, Dr. RS and you, on science of cosmetics and personal care products. Today we are in part 73. We will discuss about natural hair colorant, henna. Henna leaf is fresh leaves are made into paste. People generally squeeze little lemon into that paste. Allow it for 3-4 hours and then apply on the hair. Leave it overnight for coloring. Or people use henna powder. Right? Now, henna, pure henna generally gives reddish brown color to the hair. If the henna gives black color to the hair, it is always blended with paraffinolidine diamine, which is the synthetic dye, which oxidative hair dye, which we discussed in the part 72. So, pure henna, if it is used as a hair color, it will give reddish brown color on the hair. Of course, on the skin and nails also, they're all keratin, right? So now, what we will do is, application of henna is straightforward. We will see the chemistry of how the henna colors, right? What is the coloring pigment and how it colors the hair, or basically hair that can be extended to skin and nail. So, henna, part used leaves from Lazonia inermis, family Lythraceae. The henna plant is native to North Africa, India and Australia. Use of henna began thousands of years ago, but today henna products have made their presence worldwide for hair care, hair coloring and skin decorations. So, what are the key constituents of henna according to the classical textbooks, right? All classical textbooks gives lazone, tannin, gallic acid, fats, resins, coumarin, sugars, flavonoids, xanthone, quinoids, phenolic, glycosides, very important, cetosterol, glucosides, right? When you pluck the fresh henna leaves and analyze for lazone, You can't identify lazone. Lazone is not present in henna leaves. Right? But all classical textbooks gives lazone 1-2%. Then, what is lazone, which is the coloring principle of henna and how it colors the hair? Lazone is not present as free molecule in leaves of henna, but it is derived from its precursor, the henocides, during henna preparation. Henocides are three isomers, henocides A, B and C. The A glycone, this is a glycoside. So, henocides are glycosides. Okay? Glycosides will have a glycone part and a glycone part. Glycone part is sugar, a glycone part. The a glycone part, derived from the hydrolysis of henocides, is further converted by oxidation into lazone. That is the dyeing active compound, dyes. It colors the hair keratin. Okay. Is it so straightforward? No? Let us see. Lazone released from henna is facilitated when the powdered henna leaf material is mixed with mildly acidic medium, about pH 5.5 paste. Mix is ideal. In this mildly acidic paste, pH, the lazone molecule can be released and migrate from henna paste to stain the keratin protein. Keratin, the protein. So, this is the glycoside that is present in henna, henocytes, right? In the presence of enzymes, this is present in henna, glycosidase, right? This is the enzyme present in henna leaves. In the presence of, and when you make it as a paste, in the presence of water, it dissociates into a glycone part and sugar part. This A glycone part further get oxidized to lazone. This is lazone, right? In what happens? Neither henocytes, nor lazone will color the hair. It is the A glycone part of it which colors the hair. What happens when the A glycone part is released? It gets attached to the keratin protein of the hair and then gets oxidized to lazone and forms keratin, lazone keratin complex. Okay. Now, in mildly acidic henna paste at room temperature, the A glycone will become available after 8 hours after soak and remain at a maximum in the paste for 12 to 24 hours. What happens? 12 to 24 hours, at that stage it will be the maximum content. After that it will get oxidized to lazone. So when it gets oxidized to lazone, what happens? After which the percentage of bindable A glycone, this binds to keratin and gets oxidized lazone subsequently and form this complex. So if the bindable A glycone will gradually diminish, this process is termed as the demise of henna paste. At this point, henna paste produces diminishing stains. The color it can produce will diminish. This transformation is gradual at room temperature. This sequence proceeds more rapidly in warm condition and slow under cold conditions. So what happens? Henocytes get converted into A glycone and glycone, and this glycone get attached to the keratin, forms a complex. Subsequently, the dark brown color, it's oxidized to lazone keratin complex, right? Actually, this lazone is not soluble in water. You get lazone and try to color the hair, it will not color the hair. Or the pure henocytes will not color the hair. It has to have these enzymes, the henocytes, the moisture and oxidation subsequently. So oxygen should be present, the moisture should be present, the henocytes should be present and the glycosides. So good henna will have high content of henocytes, not lazone. The content of lazone in pure lazone in henna has no meaning. It is not the coloring. It will not, the content of henocytes are important, right? Because lazone does not color the hair, but the A glycone which is formed by the hydrolysis of henocytes, that colors the hair. The sequence of lazone migrating from henna to bind the protein in the outer layer of the skin or hair is this lazone keratin. Will give lazone keratin complex plus water. So unlike the oxidation hair dyes, where a smaller molecule gets inside the hair and becomes bigger molecule and gets locked inside the hair, that is one mechanism. Here the mechanism is entirely different. Binds to the keratin and it's a permanent color because it binds to the keratin. Only the new hair which grows have the original color. The So, for binding, lozone will not bind, only the aglycone will bind and get oxidized, and you get the dark brown color. So, to summarize, I have put here, so it is a summary, it's easy for you to understand. Enocytes A, B, C, in the presence of the enzyme glycosidase at pH 5.5, gets converted this to aglycone, and this aglycone binds to keratin and get oxidized. Lozone bound with keratin. Keratin is the hair protein. Neither the enocytes nor the final lozone will bind as effectively to keratin as this aglycone. Okay? The same chemistry can be applied to coloring skin and nail by henna, since the composition of the outermost layer of the skin and nails are primarily keratin, like hair. Lozone is insoluble in water. Has enocytes present in fresh leaves, it has to be applied on the hair for coloring. Enocytes are soluble in water. The conversion of enocytes to aglycone and oxidation of aglycone to lozone should happen on the hair for binding of lozone to keratin of the hair and thus imparting effective coloration. The sequence of lozone migrating, actually this is the equation, this is the lozone keratin complex that gives that color. So slowly it gets oxidized. When it gets oxidized, the color intensity improves. Right? This is the mechanism of the hair color using henna. So this is what I want to discuss with you today. This is very, very important. Just applying henna for coloring is one thing, but understanding how it works might be interesting. That's what I want to share with you. Thank you for listening to me patiently, and till I get connected with you all in the next part, bye to you all. Be smiling, be happy, be safe. Thank you.